Good afternoon to one and all. I am Mandar Kadekar.
I am Ashish Shingnapure.
And we are from River Godavari. So welcome to all of you on the day 3 of the induction presentation. So I want to ask you guys one question, that what comes in your mind when I say international furniture brand? Yeah, that was very quick. That's our topic for today, the rise of IKEA in India.
Yes. Contents. Introduction.
What is IKEA?
IKEA in India.
Products which comes under the IKEA.
Statistics.
Reasons of rise of IKEA in India.
Competitors.
Marketing strategy.
Distribution channel for IKEA in India.
And the conclusion.
Yes. Are you guys hungry? It's time to go to take your lunch. Why we choose the topic of IKEA? Because when I was in Hyderabad, why we choose the topic of IKEA in India? Because same situation happened in Hyderabad. At that time, I was stuck in traffic because of people. There is huge crowd in front of IKEA store. There were 40,000 people in front of visited in IKEA store at that time. That's why IKEA know everyone because of that huge rush. Introduction. IKEA. The founder of IKEA is Ingvar Kamprad, founded in 1947 in Sweden. Headquarter is in Netherlands. The CEO is Jesper Brodin. IKEA have number of 423 stores in all over the India, situated in 43 cities. Also, IKEA have also 20 lakh of customers visited to IKEA store in Hyderabad store.
So now, what is IKEA? Is it anybody's name or something? No. It's a short form. IKEA, where I and K stands for the founder, that is Ingvar Kamprad, and E and K were the it's a native place where he all grew up.
IKEA in India. The first retailer store opened in 9 August 2018 in Hyderabad, which area have 4 lakh square feet, that is 13 acres. Number of products they have in one store 7,500, and they have workers of 950 direct workers and also 1,050 indirect workers.
So the products which comes under IKEA, so basically IKEA is a furniture store. So in furniture there are very different category segments, where office furniture, home furnitures, kitchenware and textiles, many more, bathroom products, kitchen and appliances. So these are some products. Actually, these are the actual photographs which I have taken, and I would like to thank my friend Ketan, who clicked that photograph, visited the store few months back.
How many of you visited Hyderabad, and how many of us visited IKEA store? Yeah, great. Statistics. IKEA India did 2.4 crore on its opening day. Expected revenue is less by 25.55%.
Expected. So before the opening of the IKEA, so the members thought that the expectations were high, but the revenue that collected, the expected revenue was less by 25.55%. So they were not up to their expectations, but they are doing great. So reasons of rise of IKEA in India. So mainly there are many reasons why IKEA became so popular in India within a short span of time. But mainly I will point out to some four reasons. First, IKEA offers everything under one roof. So it's a one-stop destination. All types of furniture, whether it is home furniture, office furniture, kitchenware, bathroom products and textiles, it comes under one store. So you have to not rush to any other store for other products. Second, IKEA's prefabricated furniture and goods. So today's generation need quick services and good quality. So IKEA offers it all under one roof. Third, IKEA's familiar brand name amongst urban Indians. So behind this, the market, the marketing plan of the IKEA is very good. They have a very good social media command. Third, IKEA's different plans. So what are the plans that IKEA put forward for the rise in the India? So mainly there are, I would like to tell you that there are about 40 to 44% of women employees in IKEA Hyderabad store. So they are more focusing about the women empowerment in the coming years. So they have many different plans came to promote women empowerment for their health awareness and benefits for the children. So these are some of the competitors of IKEA, such as Neel Kamal, Godrej Interio, Durian and Damru. So these are the competitors with their revenue, Damru, Durian, Neel Kamal, Godrej Interio. So their revenue is about 100 to 200 crores annually. But and the products you see, Damru is only selling about sofas, beds and all. Durian, bedroom and office furniture. Neel Kamal, mostly the VC chairs about Neel Kamal, plastic molded chairs. But in IKEA, these all products are covered. All the products are come under one roof. So we don't have to look any other brand. So IKEA is doing that. And we say that the revenue collected is about 100 to 200 crore annually. But assume that, as Ashish told, that the opening day collection of the IKEA store was 2.4 crores. Assume that it's only 1 crore. The average revenue of the IKEA store whole year for one day is 1 crore. So in a year, there are 65 days. So calculate it, the results are in front of you. So about 340 to 350 crores is the annual revenue of IKEA store, only one store. And here the stores are 40 to 50 stores are there all around the India. So only one store of IKEA can generate about 320 to 340 crore roughly. So this is the main difference IKEA made with only one store.
Yes.
So Ashish, I am now very eager to know what's the marketing strategy of IKEA.
Yes, its main point of marketing strategy. Before launching the product, they visited more than 1,000 homes and they understand what they want to buy from furniture store and the other stores, and they understand their needs. The first point is using autos equipped with VR goggles. Their marketing strategy is they use VR goggles in the auto rickshaw and they show different types of video inside and outside the IKEA store. That's why people attract on that store. And also they put empty boxes in the airport and put the sticker of IKEA on that box, because people curious about that boxes, what is that strategy and what that box shows in the airport. Also there is 1000 seating capacity of IKEA hotel inside the IKEA store, and in that this one is India's biggest store in the India. Also they provide wish list on their website, and also they consider if anyone shopping mall or shopping center provide the bus services from their store to your home, then everyone want to go there in the holiday or free time. The distribution channel for IKEA in India.
Distribution channel for IKEA in India is that mostly the furniture with the designer are there, thousand plus designer are there for design the furnitures. So first supplier, where the furniture is manufactured, there are many suppliers for IKEA. Then after the furniture is manufactured, they are kept in the warehouse. From warehouse, there are kept in the store. And after, so there are customers.
Conclusion. Thank you.